So now we are going to study about integral domains and fields. See here, a ring is called an integral domain if it is commutative, first condition, second has unity element, and third is without zero divisors. The most important example of an integral domain is the ring I of integers. We know that I is a commutative ring with unity. The first two conditions are fulfilled. Also, I does not possess zero divisors. We know that if AB are integers such that AB is equal to zero, then either A or B must be zero. Since I does not possess any zero divisors and is a commutative ring with unity element, therefore it is an integral domain. So set I of integers is an integral domain. Similarly, the algebraic structure C plus dot, C means set of complex numbers with respect to addition and multiplication, is an integral domain. Q plus dot, set of rational numbers with plus and dot, is an integral domain. R plus dot, set of real numbers with plus and dot are, this is also an integral domain. These are all infinite integral domains, but a finite integral domain is the ring 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, plus 5 and cross 5. So it is addition modulo 5 and multiplication modulo 5. So it is also an integral domain, but it's a finite integral domain. See, what do you mean by invisible elements in a ring with unity? See, in a ring, every element possesses additive inverse. See, additive inverse. Other inverse are, just suppose 2 is, inverse of 2 is 1 by 2, but additive inverse of 2 is minus 2 in case of set of integers. Therefore, the question of an element being invisible or not arises only with respect to multiplication. If R is a ring with unity, then an element A in R is called invisible if there exists B in R such that AB is equal to 1 is equal to BA. Also, then B can be written as A to the power minus 1 or A inverse. See examples. 1 and minus 1 are the only two invisible elements of the ring of all integers. In case of ring of all integers, 1 and minus 1 are the two invisible elements satisfying this rule. Second, n by 2 non-singular matrices with real numbers as elements are the only invisible elements of the ring of all n by n matrices with elements as real numbers. The matrices should be non-singular. Non-singular means their determinant should be non-zero. Now, come to the definition of field. A ring R with at least two elements is called a field if it is commutative, say second has unity, and third is such that each non-zero element possesses multiplicative inverse. For example, the ring of rational numbers Q with plus and dot means addition and multiplication. There are two compositions. It is a field. Since it is a commutative ring with unity and each non-zero element is invisible in the set of rational numbers, each non-zero. Suppose we have a rational number 2 by 3. So there will be also be a rational number 3 by 2. So then their multiplication is 1. And hence each non-zero element possesses inverse or is invisible. Second, the ring of real numbers and complex numbers are also examples of field. As an example of a finite field, we have the ring of 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, addition modulo 5 and multiplication modulo 5. See, if A and B, B be non-zero are elements of a field F, then we shall write AB inverse is equal to A by B or it is equal to B inverse A. In a field F, A by B plus C by D is equal to AB inverse plus CD inverse. It is equal to BD inverse into BD within bracket AB inverse plus CD inverse. It is equal to BD inverse into within bracket BD AB inverse plus BD CD inverse. It is equal to BD inverse AD plus BC, since BB inverse cancels and BB DD inverse cancels. So it is AD plus BC. So it is equal to AD plus BC by BD. Also A by B into C by D is equal to AB inverse CD inverse. So it is equal to AC. B inverse D inverse, it is equal to AC BD inverse. It means it is AC by BD in a field. Next, we have a theorem. See here, very important theorem. It was asked several times. Every field is an integral domain. See, this is our field, and earlier we have studied about integral domain. But here, see theorem. Every field is an integral domain. See here, proof. Since a field F is a commutative ring with G unity, therefore, in order to show that every field is an integral domain, we should show that a field has no zero divisors. Since in an integral domain is a commutative ring with unity and no zero divisors, so for a field to be integral domain, we need to show that it has no zero divisors. Suppose AB be two elements of F, and A is non-zero such that AB is equal to zero. Since A is non-zero, it means A inverse exists. We can multiply both sides by A inverse. So AB is equal to zero implies A inverse into AB, it is equal to A inverse into zero, or it implies A inverse AB is equal to zero, since it is multiplication is associative. So it is equal to 1 into B equal to zero, since A inverse A is equal to 1, and it implies that B is equal to zero. Similarly, suppose AB is equal to zero and B is non-zero, then B inverse exists, and we can multiply with B inverse. So AB into B inverse equal to zero into B inverse, or AB B inverse equal to zero, or A inverse is zero. It means A is equal to zero. Therefore, in a field, AB is equal to zero implies A is zero or B is zero. So the field has no zero divisors. Hence, every field is an integral domain. So it is proved. But the converse is not true. Converse means every integral domain need not be a field, or every integral domain is not a field. For example, see, the ring of integers is an integral domain, and it is not a field. The only inversible elements of the ring of integers are 1 and minus 1. So the ring of integers is not a field. It means every integral domain need not be a field. See, there is one more theorem for you, an important one. See, theorem, see, a finite commutative ring without zero divisors is a field. Every integral domain is not a field, but here, see, a finite commutative ring, finite, it should be finite, without zero divisors is a field, or every finite integral domain is a field. Earlier we have seen that every integral domain need not be a field, but every finite integral domain is a field. See here the word finite. See here emphasis is given here. So it's proof. Let D be a finite commutative ring without zero divisors and having an elements a1 into so on n. For proving that D is a field, we need to produce an element 1 in D such that 1 into A is equal to for all A in D. For all A in D, it should be, this relation should be true. Also, we should show that for every element A not equal to 0 in D, there exists element B in D such that BA is equal to 1. Let A be not equal to 0 and it belongs to D. Now consider the n products AA1, AA2, so on AN. All these are elements of D, no doubt. They are all distinct. See how they are distinct. Suppose AI is equal to AJ, means suppose they are not distinct for I not equal to J. So it will imply that A into A minus AJ is equal to 0. Since D is without zero divisors and A is non-zero, we have taken earlier A is non-zero. So AI minus AJ will be 0 for this to be true. It means AI is equal to AJ. It contradicts our earlier supposition that A, this is for I not equal to J, but these are equal to I is equal to AJ. Therefore, A1, A2, and so on, AN, they are all the n distinct elements of D placed in some order, obviously. So one of these elements will be equal to A, definitely. Or one of these elements. Thus, there exists an element, suppose C belongs to D such that AC is equal to A, this is equal to CA. We show that this element C is the multiplicative identity of D. Suppose y be an element of D, then from the above discussion for some x in D, we have ax is equal to y is equal to x a. See here, from here we have this one. Now multiply y with c, so c y is equal will be c into ax. From here y is equal to ax. This is equal to c a into x. This is equal to a into x. Since c a is equal to a, and ax is equal to y, so c y is equal to y, and this is equal to y c. Since d is commutative, therefore c y is equal to y. It is equal to y c. It means for all y and d, therefore c is the multiplicative identity. It is the unity element of the ring, and we denoted by 1. Now 1 belongs to D, therefore from the above discussion, one of the n products should be equal to 1. A1, A2, so on an, one of these will be equal to 1. Thus there exists an element B in D such that AB is equal to 1 and it will be equal to BA since D is commutative. Therefore B is the multiplicative inverse of the non-zero element A in D. Since A is non-zero and if we have a relation BB is equal to 1 is equal to BA, it means B is the multiplicative inverse of this non-zero element A and D. Thus, every non-zero element of D is invertible. It means since A is non-zero and we have an inverse of it as B, such that AB is equal to 1 is equal to BA, it means every non-zero element of D is invertible, hence D is a field. Again, it is true. So, you need to note down all of them. And if you have any query or any difficulty, you may ask me here. First, you note down all of them. You can WhatsApp me or email me also. And all these lectures are available on YouTube also. If you miss to attend the class, you can watch the YouTube video and you can get the concepts clear.